It's very upsetting. You know, the team is quite distraught at the moment. It's now the second time that we come really close in a semi-final. It's just we somehow don't get over that hurdle. So yeah, everybody's hurting and that hurts me. As a team, we came here to play cricket. We did not look at the radars. We did not look at the weather. We felt like if we want to go to the final, we have to beat the best in the world. And everybody was up and about and ready to play the game. And yeah, I cannot fault my teammates one bit in any facet of that game. I have to give credit where it's due, and Australia bowled really well. You know, they bowled to their plans and they restricted us. Yeah, that's where it should be. Obviously, I'm not going to sit here and lie and say you don't think about it, but you know, I have to give credit to the ground staff. They did absolutely everything to keep us on that park. So, and again, we are here to play cricket, and I'd rather lose than get a free pass into the World Cup final. I knew it's a big game in the context of the World Cup, and you know, no stone will be left unturned to get the game on the way. So I had a feeling in my heart we'd get on the park, and you know, everybody stayed focused. Everybody did their pre-match prep in the indoor nets, and yeah, it's good that we could get the first 20 in. You know, and it's good that we got a game in. I guess the experience in knockout games. I mean, let's be honest, we've only been in three, so they've been in countless. So I think, but I have to give them credit, their plans are spot on. The way they started the tournament to where they are now, it shows you the quality of their team. You can never write off, you know, the number one team in the world, and they showed tonight why they are and how they came back. You know, at a stage there was our game to win and their game to lose, and they just turned the tables again. And that comes with experience, comes with confidence. And again, that I believe they are the deserved number one team in the world at the moment. I feel like Sune and Wolfi did really well. They changed the momentum there in the middle of the back end of the innings. And I was still quite confident when Chloe went out there, even with the last over. It's three hits away, especially for somebody with her power. Unfortunately, she miscued a full toss. 9 out of 10 times she'll hit that probably onto the roof. So, you know, that's the nature of the game. It's never easy to come in and just swing away, no matter how strong you are. So, no, I think Chloe came in at the right time. I think the second last over was bowled brilliantly. So I think that stopped the momentum a little bit. She's a smart kid, first of all. She loves the game of cricket. The fact that she gave up medicine to play cricket, that says a lot. So, you know, she, again, as I said, she loves cricket. She just wants to bat all the time. She gets upset if she doesn't bat. She gets upset when she sits on the side, and it showed in this World Cup. She wanted to be out there. She actually apologized for not getting the last runs, and I was like, you couldn't have done anything more. So, no, I think for somebody like her, it's easy. The hunger to play for a country is always there, and it's for every player. Yeah, she's been brilliant. She's been my pick of the tournament as well. She's been brilliant. Yeah, she was pretty close, but as I said, we do not take chances on health. Doesn't matter how important the game is. Hopefully in the near future we'll be in the same situation and she'll be there. I can say I was with her when the decision was made, and it was very difficult to get her to accept the no. She was also in tears and very emotional. But yeah, I have to give credit to Nadine de Klerk. What a standout performance tonight with the ball. She came to me, she had a plan, and it's always nice when a bowler comes to you and they're so confident with what they want to do. She didn't get much time to play, and it shows you the quality that we have. She picked up her hand incredibly well. So I was very happy with the bowling innings, bar my incredible figures. Everybody probably knows our hashtag, and it's We Are More. So the culture within this team is we're more than just cricketers. We are wives, we're daughters, we're sisters, we're aunts. You know, we're a lot more than that. So for us, that comes first, and Kapp is my wife, so I'm definitely not going to jeopardize her health. Yeah, I think that sums it up. It's just, it's a game of cricket for your health. I don't think it's worth it. She was dearly missed tonight. But again, I can't take away anything from anyone. as I said, the culture within the team is incredible. This team's incredible. I wish you guys can be in the changing room with us all the time.